seen, I've gone through the same thing which you're going through now. So you have one example in front of you.
Yeah.
When you say you like dance, so why don't you start practicing?
Yeah, I have to start practicing dance, because when I was doing dance, I was really the happiest.
Then, and see, you yourself, you're telling.
Yeah.
Tumhara solution tumhare paas hi hai beta. You have your own solution, but you are not looking at yourself. You are looking outside. Go inside. Go within. Don't worry about anything. Sab theek ho jayega.
विश्वात्मके देवी येणे वाग्यज्ञे तोषावे तोषोमि मज द्यावे पसायदाहि
Why am I feeling so excited? Is it some kind of premonition or anticipation? I want to move, but my body just does not respond. As if all my muscles are frozen. I think this is my destination syndrome. I'm always nervous of reaching a destination. The uncertainties of the new place and people are scary. While traveling, I always wish that the journey should never end, so that I can endure in the same comfort zone, as in Newton's law of inertia. But alas, every journey has to conclude and a new one has to begin. I come from a family of academicians, not dancers. So for me, the most important condition used to be you should score well in school. So my dance class was a gift for me after getting distinction in matriculation. The nearest dance class was Bharatanatyam. But I was very lucky, I got a very good Bharatanatyam guru also, Guru Mani. When I expressed my desire to learn Odissi, he never stopped me. In fact, he was the one who encouraged me and told me where the dance workshop is. And I started learning from Guru Keluchand Mahapatra. Guruji very happily accepted me because he used to be very happy to get Bharatanatyam dancers as his students. Somehow, from the day one, I got that special connection with Guruji, and I started learning from him. Guruji not only taught us dance, but whole approach towards art. He not only taught me the technique of Odissi, but how you come to that technique, the choreography. He used to choreograph in front of us. So that's why I always say, whenever I choreograph, it's not me, it's Guruji only is choreographing through us. Whatever I'm doing, I feel it's his blessing. I just want to give them whatever I've got from my Guruji. The same tradition should continue.
Odissi is an Indian classical dance style from eastern part of India. Until the turn of the last century, this dance used to be performed in the temples of Odisha. Now, we are going to present a different theme which is more spiritual in its content.
This whole part could have been on that level.
It's nice actually.
थोड़ा लेवल पे अच्छा लगता था या नीचे अच्छा लगता था? It's me.
You'll never be satisfied.
One should never be satisfied. They thought we'll stop there only. Actually.
What do your students think about this? Are you always like that with them also?
Always. They are so annoyed with me for changing everything every time. But you know, of course I don't change just before performance, but when I do choreography, I keep on changing.
I want you to tell me, you know, when you were married, were you as obsessed with all of this?
Always. He was a singer and he used to sing for me. So we used to perform together. For me, marriage was everything at that time. I used to give up my performances for his performance. Suppose if he has a musical concert, I will just go and sit there with him just to watch his performance and give up my dance performance. Although I wanted to be totally into dance, but I was not, because that is what my tradition taught me, that I have to be a good housewife.
जब मुझे चेत हुआ, तो मैंने पाया कि हाय ये सीमा कैसी, मैं तो वो हूँ जिसे दिग्वधु कहते हैं, कालवधु, समय और दिशाओं की सीमाहीन पगडंडियों पर अनंत काल से अनंत दिशाओं में तुम्हारे साथ साथ चलते चले आ रही हूँ, चलते चले जाऊंगी। इस यात्रा का आदि न तो तुम्हें स्मरण है न मुझे, और अंत तो इस यात्रा का है ही नहीं मेरे सहयात्री। सुनो मेरे प्यार, वो क्या तुम्हारा संकल्प है जो धरती में सौंदापन बनकर व्याप्त है, जो जड़ों में रस बनकर खींचता है, कोपलों में फूटता है, पत्तों में हरियाता है, फूलों में खिलता है, फलों में गदरा आता है। यदि इस सारे सृजन, विनाश, प्रवाह और अविराम जीवन प्रक्रिया का अर्थ केवल तुम्हारी इच्छा है, तो जरा ये तो बताओ मेरे इच्छा में तुम्हारी इस इच्छा का अर्थ कौन है? कौन है वो जिसकी खोज में तुमने चांद और सूरज को भेज रखा है? कौन है जिसकी आत्मा को तुमने फूल की तरह खोल दिया है? और कौन है वो जिसे नदियों जैसे तरल घुमाव दे देकर तुमने तरंग मालाओं की तरह अपने कंठ में, वक्ष पर, कलाइयों में लपेट लिया? वो मैं हूँ मेरे प्रियतम, वो मैं हूँ।
Why do you think it fell apart?
That's the question. I mean, it's still haunting me. I don't know why it happened and how. Sometimes I feel that's destiny. Maybe I was supposed to do only dance.
When Rajesh left, my mind was not ready to accept the reality. I felt like I was resting under a protective tree, and I was crushed by the same tree.
Rajesh's email, I searched for his passport. The missing passport confirmed that whatever was mentioned in the email was already executed. Rajesh had written that he is leaving the worldly life and going to London in some undisclosed ashram to start a new life. New life? Can anybody suddenly decide to leave everything and go to an ashram, that too in London? I was begging Ganesh and my family to hide this from everyone so that when he comes back, he won't feel awkward to meet people.
I remember that day that I would call it as a fateful day, I think. This Rajesh David called me up in the morning at around 10 o'clock on my landline book. There was no mobile that time for me, at least. He said that, Ganu, I have sent an email, just check the email. That's what he said. I was dumbfounded and shocked and aghast at that entire email which was given. He has said that he has given up this world and then he is going for spiritual things. So he said, you take the mail and give it to her and then you tell her, make her understand and tell her to be calm. Then everything will be all right in times to come. So I really felt, you know, the tears were just rolling in my eyes. I didn't know what to do. I said, if you had told me, I would have bashed that guy 4-5 and then hit him and said, what is the issue? You tell me, what is the issue? We'll sort it out. See, these kind of things happen in many people's lives, but you need to sort it. You can't just hide it and run away from life. It's actually run away. It's a cowardice, actually. It's a coward act which has been done. See, it took a long time for her to cope. In fact, she was still hoping for almost another 6 months and she wanted to find out what exactly was the cause. She really had to undergo a lot of ordeals actually, which she can, because the person whom she was with for 16 years and long and then whom she used to take so much care, she really felt cheated. I think almost for a year, I could not see her in a proper frame of mind. She was not able to concentrate on the profession at all.
Sleeping on a long journey is so amusing. Sometimes just before you sleep, you look out of the window to perceive the brown sand of desert and search for the mirage. Drift off to sleep and then when you open your eyes, you see white snow-capped mountains gleaming with cosmic rays or probably the lush green carpet embracing the landscape.
Each and every changing picture is beautiful. The picture on the canvas of my life also keeps on changing, whether I admire or detest it, whether I paint it with the stroke of my own brush or someone else's blow ruins it. I'm trying not to get affected by desire or like something or dislike something. I want to be fair to everything. Even my students, when they come to learn, I don't audition them. I take everyone because I feel every one of them have something in them. Some quality. God is very generous. He is fair to everyone. So even if a child is not able to learn some step, I feel he definitely has it in him. But we block our mind. Sometimes they are scared, so they can't perform. And of course, I give as much they can digest.
Being around her is always learning, I feel. Her creative thinking is absolutely out of the world. Her style of dancing, her way of teaching is so clear and so true. She is extremely good to everyone. I mean, no matter who that person is, she's extremely warm and extremely nice to that person. Even when she's angry, she's so calm and composed, and you know, she will convey whatever she wants to convey in a right way.
और क्या किया था आज हमने भूल गए सब चाय बनाते बनाते सब भूल गए यू टू रिवाइज मुझे भी रिवाइज करना पड़ रहा है बिकॉज तुम भी भूल गए मैं भी भूल गई तो हो गया फिर चेंज करना
गेटिंग आवरसेल्फ्स कोरियोग्राफ्ड फ्रॉम हर Itself gives me a different outlook towards how things can be choreographed, how a certain thing can be shown. There can be hundreds of people when I'm performing, there can be hundreds of people watching me. I can absolutely look at them and dance through, but when I know she's looking at me, it just changes everything. I have to perform well, I have to, you know, give the exact expressions, I have to give the exact pause at exact moment, and I can dance in front of 1,000 people and I'll be all right, but that one person, it just changes everything.
There is a strange, intoxicating energy in this place, but I'm feeling dull. Strangely, I'm unable to balance the trolley. After going through the whole ordeal, I came to know that he was living in London with my friend Mary, who used to organize my performances in UK. It was I who had requested her to add Rajesh's performance along with mine. Have I written my own destiny? I had made up my mind to settle in London, mainly to avoid questions about Rajesh's disappearance and my broken marriage. That time, sometime during Diwali, my father rang me up and gave me courage to go back to India. He almost cried and said, "You don't have to worry about the society and you're not at fault. Why are you avoiding your own people? Please come back. I will always be there to support you." I immediately decided to return back to India. My family gave me strength and supported me to file for divorce petition against a person whose whereabouts were unknown. My tummy feels bloated. Holding my breath, I pull in my stomach. But why am I feeling a spasm in my abdomen? Is it the tension of landing on a foreign land? Somehow, this stomach pain with a little pressure of my purse is distressing. It does not feel like a psychological tension. I convince myself it's due to the tight seat belt.
लंदन में यहाँ से जाने से उसकी तबीयत ठीक नहीं थी, ठीक नहीं थी। मैंने कहा तू गलती कर रही है, तू मत जा, तो लेकिन उसका प्रोग्राम था इसलिए वो जाने, घर से निकलते भी उसने क्रोसिन का वो गोली वगैरह ले कर दिया और फिर उधर डांस हो गया उसका पूरा। और उसने मुझे फ़ोन किया, उसने फ़ोन किया तो मैं एकदम समझ गई। मैंने कहा तुम्हारी आवाज़ ऐसी क्यों रही, क्या तबीयत ठीक नहीं है? तो बोले मैंने तुम फ़ौरन वापस आ जाओ, अभी प्रोग्राम वगैरह कुछ मत कर। तो बोल दूंगा ठीक है मैं अभी आती हूँ। मैंने उसने मुझे बताया तो मैंने इधर सब अपॉइंटमेंट्स के लिए बुक किया, मेरी ननद की लड़की को बोलकर उसके क्या टेस्ट करना है क्या नहीं सब उसके लिए सब उसके आने से पहले सब फिक्स किया था। वो आई और हम दूसरे दिन गए हॉस्पिटल में, तो उन्होंने कहा कि ऑपरेशन करना, पूरा चेकअप किया किधर कुछ गांठ है क्या है, कुछ कुछ नहीं था, एकदम क्लियर था। लेकिन जो गर्भाशय था ना, यूट्रस गर्भाशय था ना, तो उसमें था कैंसर का।
The moment I saw the report in my table, I just saw it and I could not believe my eyes. मुझे डाउट था कि ये वही रिपोर्ट है क्या। I was crying in my own heart. I think I didn't know what to do. I was in the department. I told Shubhda, then I met her. I think she was stunned. Because Shubhda is such a person, when you look at her, tears will never roll down her eyes, but she will take it in such a strong stride, you know. Ga ga pa ga re sa
re re ga re sa ni. Mrs. Shubhda. I met her probably 10 years back, and meeting her for the first time, of course she was very courageous. She was bold when she knew about what she was going through. But I think after we discussed about her problem, about the treatment, the side effects, the first thing she asked me was, will I be able to continue dancing or doing what I'm doing?
One can be a great artist, but this body, which is like a machine, will go on till the time it has been determined to cease. Sometimes I question, why me? Then I tell myself, I am not the only one with this affliction. And why not me? I ask. I am blessed with my art. Did I ask them? Why me?
बहुत फीलिंग हुआ, लेकिन अभी बोल नहीं सकते, इतना हो गया था. फिर सोचा कि अगर मैं कोलैप्स हो जाऊंगी तो वो और हो जाएगी, तो उसका सोच के फिर मैंने अपने को ये किया कि उसके सामने दिखाने का ही नहीं कि क्या है उसको, मतलब मैं डर गई हूँ या ऐसा कुछ. लेकिन मैं नहीं ऐसे होने दूंगी, ऐसे मेरे मन में मैं नहीं किया, ऐसा कुछ होने ही नहीं दूंगी जो कुछ भी हो जाए. और पूरा दिन उसकी सेवा में मैं बोलती ना, जब तक वो थी कभी मैं बाहर भी नहीं गई घर से, एक साल तो नहीं गई. टाइम पर दवा देना, टाइम पर खाना खिलाना, मेरे को कॉन्फिडेंस था कि वो नहीं रहेगा, कुछ सब ठीक हो जाएगा.
For her, actually, it was so difficult because it was like a second blow on her. First was, of course, my separation, divorce, and then again this happening in my life. On the first day when she heard about it, she cried. That was the only day she cried. And then she learned, I think, to hide her tears from me. A mom is not very ritualistic, but I have always seen her doing her puja every day. But she doesn't have blind faith in anything. She just said, you do your work, that's all. All the while she, you know, like gave me that inspiration to come back. Whenever I said I want to dance, she never said no. I never wanted to show her how much I'm suffering, even physical pain. I would always try to hide it from her, but she would guess from my movements that something is wrong.
Thank you.
मात्रच होतो माझ्या आक्रंदनाचा मारा, तुझ्या हृदयात मात्र नाही रागाला थारा. प्रेरणा तू देतेस जग जिंकण्याची, झळ तुलाच जास्त माझ्या बोलण्याची. आयुष्याच्या वजाबाकीत एकच अधिक तू, स्तब्ध आहे बाल्य माझे जोवर समोर तू. Cancer has had a tradition of several thousand years. Yesterday I read in a journal that cancer was found even in the ancient Egyptian mummies. Cancer cells are so ancient, and I have inherited something that ancient, and my body is witnessing the chaos created by it. I feel as if my nerve ends are dead. I don't know the scientific reasons for this, but it's a dreadful feeling. If I'm unable to walk, how will I dance? What a frightening thought. Never to dance again. The first week after chemo went off in bed, feeling dizzy all the time. Today I'm feeling better, but still I'm finding it difficult to control my walk. Groggy, unstable. As if there is a vacuum between floor and my feet. I recollect Dr. Sudeep's warning to me about this effect of losing sensation beneath my feet and palm. This type of detachment of our sensory system is the last thing I could have imagined happening to me.
One of the drugs that we were wanting to use in her chemotherapy regimen, and that drug is called paclitaxel. But one of its peculiar side effects is essentially some bit of a damage to the peripheral nerves that are responsible for the normal feeling of sensation as well as power. And it most often affects the fingers and the toes in a glove and stocking sort of a distribution.
He had a lot of questions about, will I survive? If I take this treatment, what are the side effects immediately and in long term, which would be bothersome for my life as well as for my profession?
He used to tell Dr. Sudeep Gupta, I have a performance after 5 days, what do I do? She said, it's very difficult, your legs are not in order, you're getting these things, you know, you have to see, but still you try. She took it and she did it. She did not miss any performance. Let me tell you, when I used to see a performance, tears used to roll down my eyes. Me and my wife, we have gone to several of her performances. And being such a person who had some problems in health problems, she is doing live on the stage.
My makeup is usually very good, and I always get compliments for that. But today, my hand is trembling. No way. I cannot mess up with my makeup at any cost. My reputation is at stake. People compliment me as beautiful classical dancer from India. I always used to hide my illness with my makeup. And, you know, at least for 1 year, nobody came to know about it. Sometimes I would put artificial lenses in my eyes and try to look very different. For me, cancer is associated with death. So I felt if I think about that, I will die every day. Instead of that, I will just forget about it. But physically, I could not. So I thought at least at some different level, let me think that I am not
affected by any of these things and let me do something which I love the most. I didn't tell anyone that I'm going through cancer because I was a little scared. People may think, oh, she's not well and they won't offer me any performance. You know, artist life is such that if you're not good, nobody is going to call you. We are freelancers. So if the news spreads that she's taking cancer treatment, organizers won't approach me. During my school days, hair used to be a big issue, as I never used to be satisfied with the way my hair was combed by Aayi. One fine day, she got annoyed with my tantrums and chopped my hair absolutely short. With the chopped off hair locks, she made two hair supplements, one for her and the other for my aunt. Those were the innocent days of childhood when I felt happy that my mother was wearing hair extension which I had provided her. But now, with inflated ego and pride, I'm worried and depressed about my hair loss.
I wash my face and look in the mirror that hangs above the basin. Who is this? No eyebrows, no eyelashes. My wig is twisted. How weird I look. This silver color piece of glass is so murderous, showing me an ugly image of myself. What is our body? Is it just a hard matter, which is also an empty space with patterns of energy running through it? Then why am I so disturbed with my ugliness? This body has been going through moments of pain, had seen the face of beauty to ugliness. Span of life moving towards death, but still, what is that energy holding me in this world? My uncle called me up and said, come home fast as soon as possible. I was wondering what happened because by now the results were out. We knew what is happening. She was already out of danger in a way. And the operation was done. She was already in her second chemo cycle. And I was like a little worried. Now what? Is there anything else? Is there some other report which has come out? So I went home and I saw Ajji crying. I asked her what happened. She just wiped her tears like all mothers do. And she said, nothing, come home. So I went inside, Shubho was almost sleeping. So I almost wake her up and I'm like, what happened? Are you all right? And there she was, she got up and there was no hair, not at all. But then that day it was really hard hitting for everyone. Suddenly, you know, I wouldn't say it defines beauty, but yeah, it is part of your body. It's you.
Wait. और ये पता कहाँ से अच्छा से रखा? As if क्या कर रहे हो तुम लोग यहाँ?
Mirror.
तो देखो खुशी से, गुस्से से मत देखो खुद को. ठीक से क्यों नाइस ब्यूटीफुल फेस देख रहे हो सुंदर सुंदर इतने दिख रहे हो.
I have to close my classes for 6 months. No income. Whatever I had earned in London is spent on my surgery. Every chemotherapy cycle will cost 20 to 25,000. The future looks very depressing.
During all the chemo cycles, I think the chemos used to be once in a month for 3-4 months. So She was to take the chemo cycle rest for 1 week and then immediately take up a performance. That was really something, because it is not easy. You know, we read, we hear so many people fighting cancer, and we know how it feels, how much pain it is, and the pain which you can't share with anyone. In the entire process, she never stopped dancing. That kept her going as well as family going, because we knew, okay, till the moment she's dancing, everything is alright.
Chemo cycle, I used to look forward for that third week of my cycle where I'm normal and I'm performing. So I used to be very careful about my treatment, and that gave me little hope that, you know, I have to do this. Today is a day of celebration. The last day of external radiation. Now just 2 more internal ones remain. God alone knows how I have managed this painful journey. Waiting for my turn in the radiation department, I try to frame my performance for Namami in my mind.
घनु बाजे धुनु गुणा मारा बाजे तृणु झुणा घनु बाजे धुनु गुणा मारा बाजे तृणु झुणा भवता
I've seen a transformation in you know, how she used to take it, I think. But she's taken up very well, and she has really fought every part of it, every bit of it. And she knows that I'm well. It's the only one thing is we always say that, you know, I'm well, I'm well, I'm well.
Opened up my mind. After going through the mental pain, physical pain, psychological suffering, I have gone inwards. And I think the whole world is in our body.
Adharam madharam vadanam.
My dance, my teaching, everything is now sharing of the beautiful moments and movements. When I am performing, I am sharing my bliss and pain of creation. When I am teaching, I am sharing my information and ignorance. The observer within me becomes more keen and enthusiastic, and my heart, like the peacock plume, pure, almost celestial.
Da, 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 da,